Hey everybody, welcome to your weight loss series. Today's video is all about pleasure for weight loss. Pleasure seems kind of like this taboo, forbidden word when it comes to the way that we eat and our health, because we view foods that bring us pleasure as bad, as naughty, as sinful. And it really does damage our relationship with food and how we're meant to connect with food. Eating should never be a struggle. You should be able to eat food that you enjoy while still being healthy, and it's our mindset that really gets in the way of that. Eating for pleasure isn't just about eating foods based on their nutrients, but it's about eating foods based on their nourishment value. So there's a difference between nutrients and nourishment. Nutrients help to build us up on a physiological level, but nourishment helps to build us up on a soul level. There are different foods that satiate our soul that have a profound impact on the way we digest and assimilate those nutrients. If you're eating foods that are bland, that you don't like because you think you should be eating them because you're following a diet, it actually inhibits the way that you're able to digest and assimilate those nutrients. Here's why. If you're eating foods that cause you stress, like the stress that comes from chronic dieting, you increase stress hormones. Last video, we talked all about stress and weight loss. Now, if we have excess stress hormones going on inside of our body, we're not able to digest, assimilate, or absorb nutrients. This is huge. If you are not digesting the food that you eat or absorbing nutrients, you're not able to lose weight and to be healthy. So if you're eating foods that cause stress, you're not going to digest them well. Conversely, if you're eating foods that cause pleasure, you induce the opposite of a stress response, which is the relaxation response, also called rest and digest. And like the word mentions, like the name mentions, when we're in that state, that parasympathetic dominance, we're able to digest and assimilate and absorb nutrients, and we're able to just relax. Our body is able to let go because it's not under stress. This does not mean eating whatever foods you fancy at any time, at any day, and having an excuse to go and eat pizza and cookies and chips and whatever other junk food you can think of. But it's about eating foods that are nutritious, but in ways that satiate you on a soul level. So if you are craving something that's maybe not so healthy, making it a little bit healthier or buying higher quality whole ingredients can really help to satiate you on a soul level. Your diet shouldn't be painful. Eating shouldn't be a struggle. You should enjoy every single meal that you eat at every single day. And if you don't, you need to ask yourself why you're not allowing yourself to experience pleasure with food. Eating for pleasure is not a bad thing when we have the foundation of eating whole foods that are nutrient rich because we want to take care of our body. Your body is meant to be taken care of. If you have that foundation laid, then you can take those foods and prepare them in ways that are satiating you and nourishing you on a soul level. Also, this doesn't mean that you would never eat those other foods that maybe aren't so nutritious, but maybe you are going over to a friend's house or family dinner, or it's over a holiday and they're all your favorite foods. Eating those things in moderation every now and then isn't a bad thing. It's actually a good thing. It can help you maintain a healthy relationship with food where you're not always afraid of eating and fearful of what you put into your mouth. It's really, really important. Eating for pleasure should be one of those tools in your toolbox that you're taking out all the time. My challenge to you this week is to find foods that satiate you, not just on a physical level, but on a soul level as well. What are your favorite foods? Take an inventory. What are your favorite foods? Now ask yourself, do you eat any of those foods in a week? Or do you not eat them because you deem them as bad or as naughty and are afraid that they're going to make you gain weight? If those foods that are on your favorite foods list are inherently not very healthy, how can you make them healthier? You can make any type of food, any meal, as healthy as you want with high quality whole ingredients. You want a burger and fries? Make it yourself. You want pizza? Make it yourself with whole healthy ingredients, and it can make a huge difference, and you still get that eating for pleasure, so you're not just eating chicken, broccoli, and rice or salad for every single meal. Your diet doesn't have to be like that. It shouldn't be like that. You should be eating foods that bring you satisfaction on a cellular level, but also on a nourishment level as well. I talk about this extensively in my book, Food Rehab for Food Junkies. If you have not picked up your copy today, please go and do so. It's available everywhere, but you can also grab yours off Amazon. I talk about how our relationship with food affects our body on a physical level and how we can change our relationship with food so we can be the best human beings that we could possibly be and have the best life that we could possibly have as well. Over the next week, I challenge you, start eating for pleasure and see how your body responds. Again, building on the foundation of whole foods, mindful eating, so we're not eating in front of the television or in front of our phones, we're not eating under stress, we're eating foods that we enjoy in ways that are prepared, that satiate us, that we like, and see how your body changes and how your mindset changes as well. The whole point of being healthy and eating healthy is changing our relationship with food. We need to do that more than just changing what we eat. And that's how we're going to see the most benefits. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave me a comment in the comment section below. Give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and I will see you next week. Bye-bye.